Does the currency that you work with change values before you have a chance to report them? Well, then you should learn how to make a home currency adjustment. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When we report financial statements or tax forms, each statement has an official date or date range. The numbers on the statements must be accurate as of the date of the statements. Since currency values change all the time, then you must adjust the value of any foreign-held currency that you own to make it the actual value as of the date of the financial statements. In our example, we will follow from the previous video. In our bank account with the Bank of Guyana, we currently have 10,000 Guyanese dollars. Last February 11, we received the first 5,000 Guyana dollars, and at that moment, February 11, they were worth 0.006 of a dollar. Then, a few days later, on February 15th, we received the other 5,000 Guyana dollars, and at that moment, February 15th, we recorded receiving them at 0.007 of a dollar. So what will QuickBooks remember? Well, of course it will remember that the US dollar equivalent of the Guyana dollars that we own is now a balance of $65 as of February 15th. And that's again because 5,000 of those Guyana dollars were acquired at 0.006, and the other 5,000 that's in the bank account were acquired at 0.007. So the first 5,000 are currently worth in US dollars 30, and the other 5,000 that were acquired later on the 15th are worth 35 US dollars. And that explains why at this moment, all 10,000 units of the Guyana dollar are equal to 65 US dollars in our records. And we can prove this by opening the account. Here we are in the trial balance, and here's the Bank of Guyana stated in US dollars. And if we double click, we can see that first we acquired 30 US dollars worth of Guyana dollars. Then we acquired 35 more US dollars worth of Guyana, and that's why it's equal to 65. If I double click and open the first one, you can see these 5,000 were received at this rate, 0.006. And if I double click the next one, you can see that the next batch of 5,000 was received at this rate, 0.007. And that explains why the balance is 65 US before our adjustment. Now, in our example, we must report our financial statements on March 1. We did not have any new transactions from February 15th, which is the last time we received Guyana dollars, until now, March 1. However, on March 1, right now, each Guyana dollar is now worth 0.008. We must update the balance of the bank account to reflect the actual value in US dollars as of the date that we report our financial statements. And to do this, we make a home currency adjustment. A home currency adjustment is an entry that we make to our QuickBooks records that adjusts for or corrects for the change in value of any foreign currency that we own. This is a change in value from the date of the last recorded transaction of that currency until the date of the adjustment, which is usually for financial statement reporting. So what does QuickBooks actually remember in our records? Well, QuickBooks remembers how much each of the individual units of currency and how much they were received at the moment that we acquired them, and that reflects the current balance. QuickBooks will change the value of the individual units in our records to reflect the currently updated value, which means instead of having half of them at 0.006 and half of them at 0.007, after the adjustment, what will happen is all of the units that we own will all become the same value, the new value per unit that we put into QuickBooks, and as a result, the balance of the foreign bank account will change in amount regarding the US dollars. So before we adjust, we have $65 in the Guyana bank account. But when we update the cost or the price of each unit, that means that the value of the whole bank account increases from $65 to $85 US dollars, and that means we have a $15 gain at the moment we adjust the value to make our financial statements correct. So what will be the result when we record this home currency adjustment on March 1? Well, the value of the Bank of Guyana has increased from $65 US dollars to $80 US dollars because of the $15 gain and the increase in the rate per each unit. And of course, because that's a gain, then exchange gain or loss here at the bottom will increase by $15, and we now have a total gain of $26.30. It's very simple to enter a home currency adjustment. You click List, Currency List. Then click on the specific currency whose value you are adjusting, and then in the bottom of the list window, click Activities, Home Currency Adjustment. Now, the most important thing is to put the date of the adjustment. This way, QuickBooks knows the value of each unit of currency from March 1 forward. You click and you choose which currency you're adjusting, and now QuickBooks shows you the most recent rate entered for the most recent transaction with the Guyanese dollar. You will change the rate to the new rate as of the day that you are reporting your financial statements. Then when you click Calculate Adjustment, QuickBooks will show you that you have a $15 gain because the balance was $65 because the rate per unit was the old rate. The new balance is $80 because now it's 10,000 units at the new rate, and the gain will be $15. You have to click in the left margin to accept that particular adjustment and then click Save and Close. Now, when we go back to the trial balance, you can see that the Bank of Guyana is now properly valued at $80 US dollars, and the exchange gain or loss is exactly as what we predicted, $26.30. You can double click and you can see that this gain was recorded as a journal entry adjustment on March 1. And it increased the gain, the overall gain, by $15 for that specific adjustment. And one final note, what else will be the result? Well, QuickBooks now remembers that all 10,000 units of the Guyana dollars we have are now each equal to 0.008, and that's why it's $80 US dollars. So that means when you pay these Guyanese dollars to a vendor in Guyana for some service that you need, QuickBooks will remember there are 10,000 units of the Guyana currency in the account, regardless of the US dollar value on the day that you pay.